that top button. Because it's right here, this is spot. And it kind of goes like right to the chakra. If I put my energy for that chakra, guess what's going to happen? You're going to see all kinds of pictures after a while. But in the meantime, see the magic finger? Sleep. All the way down. Deep sleep. All the way down. The deeper you go, the better you feel. The better you feel, the deeper you go. More relaxed. More relaxed. Even than before. Doubling, tripling, quadrupling. All of that relaxation into your body. All the way down. Absolutely wonderful. Even though I'm going to take my hand away for a second and lift your head up so you don't break your neck. That energy is going to continue to go through that spot for the rest of the session. It's going to continue to grow, continue to make that link, continue to grow and build those pictures and help take down those curtains that were there. And by the end of this, we're going to be seeing some very vivid pictures, very vivid colors. In the meantime, I want you to just relax. Not be distracted by anything else around. No matter how far you travel in this session, you cannot get in trouble. You cannot be hurt by anything that you run into. No matter how deep we go, you'll just always hear my words and follow the instructions, obey the commands, because you realize that everything I say and do is for you, to give you the life you want, the way you want it, by your standards and definitions. Just keep focusing, going deeper, 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 deeper. I want you to use that amazing imagination of yours and imagine floating right above your head is a beautiful ball of safe energy. And it's your safe energy in your safe color. I want you to know how the feelings in your body are affected by that energy being above that. And how they begin to shift and change with every breath you take and every beat of your heart. How that awesome, safe energy begins to grow, to expand, and to begin to fill that room from the floor all the way to the ceiling, from wall to wall, and all points in between, wrapping itself around you like a warm, safe, awesome blanket, protecting you from all of the external threats, real or imagined. And while at the same time, that energy feeds your entire body, mind and soul, everything it needs and everything it wants, everything it needs, an ever expanding, infinite, undiluted supply. Breathe that safe energy through your body and notice how your feelings begin to shift and change. How it fills you up. Like a bottle fills with water. Fill you up with all of that energy. Like a tube filling with liquid. The energy just rising from your feet all the way to the top of your head. And when you're completely filled with it, I want you to scan your body once over and take all the time you need in the next few minutes and notice any place that you feel tension or anxiety. These are places that sometimes store less than positive feelings or memory without our conscious knowledge and without our conscious consent, away from the brain room and tucked away into the muscles and into the cell. Perhaps a trauma that was dropped into a special container. And when you find these areas, what I want you to do is point to them if you have any. Have you noticed any of them? Right there, right there. What I want you to do is I want you to breathe that safe energy right through those two spots from the outside and expel it right out of your open mouth. Each time you take a breath in and breathe it out through your mouth, notice those spots becoming less and less. Notice them breaking apart like hot water running over an ice cube. It continues to get smaller and smaller. And notice those areas begin to dissolve and melt away as you just let that energy flow. Growing an infinite supply. Like you just turned on the tap and left it running for all the right reasons. Just keep breathing through those spots until they're completely gone. And as those spots melt away, something else begins to happen. You might begin to feel an expansion, a release, if you will, as if those dense spots, those tight spots, were somehow acting like a chain or a restraint, if you will. As if those dense spots or tight spots were holding a part of the spirit, a part there of the mind or the body, prisoner inside of those places that you just dissolved and melt away. And some people, they feel that expansion as if their body is spreading its wings and growing beyond the small confines of the physical form. And they find themselves merging into that amazing ball of self-energy, safe energy, like a drop of water merging back into the ocean from which it came. They feel a sense of reunion, reconnection. Was something much more powerful and much more loving than that small existence that they had inside of the body. Now they still maintain all of their individual aspects, things that let them know who they are and who they are to become, becomes expanded, empowered, renewed, if you will. And many clients report that often as they merge deeper and deeper into that space, then an idea comes to them, an understanding that in this place you are all powerful, that in this place anything you can act out, any anything you can intend must become real and true and manifest into the external world. Because it's interesting to note that all of the experts agree, even cutting-edge research in quantum physics, Kabbalah, Christianity, yogis, or anybody who espouses a magical doctrine, they all agree on one thing, and that is that your inner world controls and manifests your outer world. And while it's not always possible to prepare for every possible situation or circumstance that the external world might face with us, inside is much different. Inside, you are all powerful. You are the god of your neurology. You're the king of the universe. And you have every right, privilege, and authority to make any change that you want, for any reason that you want, and have those changes expressed in the outer world. Because we all realize and we all understand that it's the inner world that manifests the external one. Now, there's some feelings that you were having when you came here today, and the reason, very reason for you for even being here today. And as that energy continues from me through your neck into your chakra, opening up all of the curtains and blinds, turning the lights back on and allowing you to see, I want you for a moment to think about that initial reason that you came here today. The one bigger thing that you needed to change. And I want you to point into your body where you first feel that. Where you first feel that feeling. God, excellent. And that is a color that's associated with that energy, with that feeling. What color is it?
Purple.
Excellent. And now if you would, I'd like you to trace around that energy with your fingers and see what shape it is and how big it is. And while you do that, just describe to me what the shape is, what it feels like, what that energy is.
It's like a hill, like a mountain almost.
So I imagine it's pretty heavy.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Is it smooth when you run your finger around it?
Yeah.
Does it have a temperature?
Kind of warm.
Okay. And what I want you to do is I want you to, through your inner eye, I just want you to imagine going right to the middle of that, just on the outside, dead center of that energy. When you get there, just nod your head. Excellent. Well, now what I'd like you to do is to travel back through that energy, all the way through the middle of it, like a thread going through a needle, winding around whatever it needs to wind around, and just follow it all the way back to the very beginning, the very first scene, the or situation or instance where it first made its presence known to you. Take as much time as you want. Sometimes there's a long travel to get to the very beginning of it. When you get all the way there, just nod your head and let me know. Okay. So now that you're there, are you sure that this is the very first time that it came about? Well, looking at your hands, are they big boy hands, little boy hands, somewhere in between?
Bigger.
Bigger? If you had to guess, about how old would you say?
19, 20.
19 or 20 years old. Okay. And are you barefoot or do you have shoes on?
Shoes.
Is it daytime or nighttime?
Dead.
Are you alone or with people?
Alone.
Alone. Okay. Is it hot or cold?
It's warm. Hot.
Warm. Inside or outside?
Outside.
Outside. Okay. So you're there alone. Go ahead and tell me what's going on. Give me a report of what the story is there.
Right now it doesn't look like anything. I'm just basically outside alone. Kind of seems like back home in Ohio when I was younger. I guess on some blacktop. Cut off shirt on, shorts. Nothing's really going on. Just kind of outside alone, standing there.
Thinking about?
I guess that I'm alone.
What caused you to be alone, do you think? Was there something that happened before this that caused that?
Not that I see.
Was there ever a time before you were 19 that you had this alone feeling?
Yeah.
Let's travel back to the beginning of that time, that feeling. And at this level, what size hands do you have?
Little.
Little. So if you were to guess your age?
12, 13.
12 or 13. Are you outside?
No.
Inside. Are you alone?
No.
With people?
Family.
Are they with you or away from you?
They're with me.
They're with me. And what's going on? What's the story?
I feel like we're almost just either watching a movie or watching TV. I feel like my dad's in the other room or something. He's not necessarily with us, but he's in the same area.
You feel alone because even though there's people there?
Yeah.
Is that because your dad's in the other room?
I feel almost torn, I guess.
Torn?
I feel alone, but I don't.
so at 12 or 13, did this ever present itself before this? Ever a time where you felt alone before this?
Probably.
Do you remember a time? Where you felt alone? Felt torn in some way?
Yeah.
Let's travel down that one and follow that thread all the way to the beginning of that one. Through all of that energy, all of that twists and turns. We get to the very beginning scene of that one. Just nod your head and let me know. Okay. How old would you be at this one?
5 or 6.
5 or 6 years old. Are you alone or with people?
People.
Indoors or outdoors?
Outdoors.
Outdoors. Day or night?
Evening.
Warm or cold?
Warm.
And so here, 5 or 6, what's the story? What's going on?
At the T-ball game.
At the T-ball game. What's going on at the T-ball game?
Getting ready to hit, and my dad came over, and before I hit, told me that him and my mom were getting divorced.
And before this incident, was there ever a time where you felt alone or separated?
Not that I remember.
Never a time where you felt alone, where you were wondering where he was, where your mom was?
No.
Very cool. Very cool. Well, what I'd like you to do is I would like you to instruct your other than conscious mind to take every scene, every situation, every picture, every part of this, through all of these little tunnels, all of these places that we've gone to, from the beginning all the way up to here, take them all and have your other than conscious mind move everything up into that safe ball. Just direct it to physically take everything related to any of this, all those paths that you took to get here. Just combine it and push it up into that safe one. You notice the change that starts happening as those items start moving up into that safe one. Feel the shift and the energy change within yourself. As all of it goes up into that same place above you right now. Feel it changing? Now here's what's kind of cool. We're going to have the karma cops come in. I'm going to have them come in and take all of those incidents and drag them out, all of the karma that's related to all of those incidents. They're going to drag all the karma out and put it into a big pile. off into the distance. And you just see him running back, the massive piles of karma, going back to this big pile in the distance. Can you see that? And as they do that, the pictures just sort of combine themselves into that energy, getting cleaned. As the karma just immediately moves out. I get this big, massive pile of karma off into the corner. You know what karma is, right? Those karma cops have a really cool job. As they're going to deliver back to the people who gave this karma to you, that karma, in the amounts that they gave you this karma, and they're going to give it back to them in exactly the same way they gave it back to you, they gave it to you. So if they shot karma at you in a good way, well, they're going to get their karma back in a good way. And if it came to you in a way that was not good, or was unpleasant, or that hurt you, they will get it back in exactly the same way they gave it to you. And they run around that pile, and they grab massive handfuls, whipping it out and delivering it back to every person that karma deserves to go to throughout that entire stream, throughout that entire span. And you can see them just delivering that karma back to each person. What does little karma cops look like?
Just people.
Just people? Little people?
Yeah.
People have all kinds of stories of what they look like. One girl told me, she busted out laughing in the middle, and she was just like, oh my God, they look like minions running around, delivering it back at like lightning speed. Boom, they keep going back. And the pile continues to get smaller as they keep delivering their karma back to whoever deserved it throughout that entire life, from the beginning all the way through all those stories to where we got to. In order to get to this point, they're delivering all of that karma back. Some of it they're loading up into these big, massive things, firing it through the air. And as it gets done, as they finish up, that pile isn't very big anymore, is it? Is there anything left in that pile? Of what's there, is any of it yours? So what would you like to do with this pile? Would you like to blow it up, annihilate it, beam it to another planet? You want to incinerate it? Or just let the wind blow it away?
Wind blow it away.
Let the wind blow it away. And about that time, all the rest of that pile just completely goes away. And as you look into that safe area, that safe ball, and you look at the memories that your other than conscious mind brought up into that safe area, how are those looking now? Notice the change in those pictures?
They're smaller.
They're smaller. Are they brighter?
Yeah.
Do they look happier?
Yeah.
imagine so, being in your safe area, having all the karma removed. So now, as a safe light, you can feel it. It just starts drifting over your head and starts moving its way through your body. As it goes, those pictures start going bad, but they need to go. Things start getting replaced. The energy is completely different. Much more vibrant. Much happier times throughout the whole thing. It's going to start reshuffling them in your neurology. You'll feel some changes. And those changes are good. You can expect them to change. You can expect your feelings to change. And throughout this process, you may feel different emotions that come up as all the memories get put back in, totally cleaned up, with all the karma removed. If anything comes from it, that's fine. Just let it out, because this is a place where it needs to come out. You can feel it rewriting through your body, through all of your little nerve endings throughout your entire body. You can feel it rebuilding those pictures. Rebuilding history. Rebuilding the life to a very positive picture. Immensely happy. Immensely positive. Supercharging you as you feel that energy move through your body. You might feel twitching, you might feel hot heat, or things start to become very hot. And that would just be additional signs of your neurology cooking up. Those will continue. As it keeps rebuilding, replacing. And while that's all going on, and while you feel that incredible energy going through your body, into every cell, like right down into your DNA, working through and changing. I want you to notice that picture of that energy that you had initially of it. Is it still there? Head out in front of me.
Not that I see.
It's not there. Go ahead and try and bring it back and notice what happens instead.
It's flattened out.
It's flattened out. What does it feel like?
I feel like goo.
Kind of like goo. What I want you to do is, I want you to take your hands and that picture of it. I just want you to shrink that picture of that energy all the way down to like the size of a postage stamp. So go ahead and use your hands and close that picture all the way up to like a postage stamp. Real tight. Get it all down small. I want you to take and throw that behind you as far as you can. Yeah. You know the sound that a nail gun makes? That little postage stamp gets nailed into a wall behind you somewhere, way behind you. try and bring that little postage stamp back. Can you bring it back?
No, it's different.
It's different. It's gone. How does it feel now that it's gone?
Good.
Feels good, just good.
Like calming.
Like calming? And now that that's gone, what do you see in your mind's eye?
Space.
Space. What's going on in the space?
Just open, like an open room almost.
Like an open room?
It's white. Almost like room for anything, I guess.
Like a new pal?
Yeah.
Ready for a new adventure?
Mm-hmm.
Ready for something new to come along and fill it? That void that's been there for so long? Which is exactly what's going to happen. As you move on into a new adventure and paint that new picture with certainty of the things that you want to manifest into your life, things you wish to become. But the other issues now out of the way and long gone, nailed to trees far in the past. And when you know that this new program is put into all the right places, exactly right for you. Even though it'll be overwriting the old program for a while yet, you know the new pieces are all what they need to be. Go ahead and open your eyes and see just how good the world looks now.
Takes me a second to get over.
That's all right. You smiling?
Yeah.
Hey, Bill.
Feel good. I do.
Mm-hmm. What feels different?
My neck's not sore right now. Like I said, I feel a lot more calming, a lot more peace. Just able to kind of relax.
You can do that with the safe light anytime you want. It's your light. It's not necessarily like a meditation, but you go into a peaceful spot, and if you have places that are dark or heavy, you do the same thing. You just breathe that light through them, expel them, you know? And you can break those pieces apart, most of them, by yourself, just by breathing that light in and letting everything else go right out. Do you remember all that from what we were doing?
Yeah, I think so.
Okay. And it will, you know, I won't say I do it every night, but a lot of nights out of the week, you know, I'll do that. Throw something on, I'll just listen to the music calmly. If I find a spot, I'll just breathe through it, expand it out. I do have a question, which I should have asked you when you came in, because if you say no, I should have thrown yes. So did you?
Huh?
Did you? Download the priming exercise and start doing that?
No. I thought about it several times, too.
That's helpful. Not.
It'll be the first thing on the list.
Thank you. You will notice it will make a great deal of difference to you.
In the morning?
Yep. Literally like the first light. And you can, you know, like, some people do that for like 30 minutes, some people do it for longer, you know, depends what your schedule is like.
Mm-hmm.
But the first wave of it goes to do with gratitude, and every day you kind of expand on that. Be for your family, you know, and eventually that comes out. And the second part is things and goals that you want to accomplish. Those expand it.
Mm-hmm.
And lastly are the things that you're going to accomplish that day, which gives a lot of focus and power to that. And now that you're cleaned out of a lot of the past and stuff, you can really focus on the stuff you really want to get going.
Mm-hmm.
And you do that breathing exercise. Well, I hope you get a jump start on virtually every day. And you'd be amazed how quickly you go through the things that you put on that list first thing in the morning. You know?
Mm-hmm.
You'll find that you'll put some things on there, and then later on you go, well, that was kind of ridiculous. Oh, that was just so quick. Yeah.
Do you write them down?
You can. I don't usually. Only because I write so much else now, so many other things, right? That those three that you come, that I come up with anyway, in the morning, usually I don't forget, because they become the focus of the day. And they're usually somehow related to things I need to do for either for me, for the business, for somebody else. A lot of times it's me just getting ready for other people. I just make it look easy. It's a lot of work. Sometimes it's a lot of work. Because there's a lot I feel when I go through there with you.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So it's, well, I don't know exactly what all the stories were, you know, some of the things you share. But it's like, which direction or where is actually the beginning?
I feel like there's a lot of blocks in there, or where a lot of blocks.
Yeah, you're like somebody threw blocks at you when you were a kid.
Just stacked them all up.
But a lot of them you built yourself,
yeah,
as a wall of protection. And which is normal, okay, but you built a wall of protection at like 3 and 5 years old, okay, which was like a castle then,
mm-hmm,
and gets stronger because you keep adding on layers of bullshit to this story that may have been very real at 3 or 5, but even the exact contents of it now probably wouldn't be very relevant.
Mm-hmm.
But the wall keeps getting stuff added throughout the years. Now, a lot of that just got annihilated. Most of that just got crushed in getting into that earlier age. And you're going to feel a lot of change. I don't know, do you feel it there?
Feel
you
more
feel
clear.
Inside of your body at the moment. You feel the electricity going through?
I do. Kind of.
Mm-hmm.
I guess. But ultimately, like, I feel more clear.
Mm-hmm.
There's less going on.
And there will be, because you cleared out stress, you cleared out shit that you worry about that you don't even realize you're worrying about. Okay? If you deal with something, it takes this much energy. To repress something takes this much energy. and the more that you repress, which can be like anything you don't want to deal with. I don't mean like big things you want to forget.
Mm-hmm.
But it takes twice as much energy. So yeah, just simply by eliminating it,
yeah,
you'll feel much better. You'll have more energy. And if you do the priming,
which I will, I am.
You heard that, right? Everybody heard that?
They heard.